Hey guys, so I just wanted to share with you my new fitness goal that I'm going to be doing every single Saturday. I'm not a runner by any means. I actually grew up in a small town that was really big on cross country and track and had an amazing, amazing group of talented athletes and a great coach. And I was never a part of it, and I always kind of watched from the outside. And my best friend growing up in high school was involved. So it was always something that I heard about, and I was, you know, just really hesitant to start even thinking about doing for myself. I have asthma, and you know, I dreaded the mile when I was in middle school and high school, so this is totally out of my element. But I really want to start getting into running 5Ks and halves and maybe one day a marathon, and that's totally far off in my future, but I want to share with you right now where I'm starting. So my goal and my training schedule is pretty simple. Every Saturday I'm going to run a 5K on my own, 3.1 miles, and I'm going to track using the Nike running app my average pace, my best mile, my best 1K time, and my best 5K time. And the Nike running app makes it super simple. It's free. It uses GPS, so it tracks your runs and it keeps the data for as long as you have it on your phone, so you can see your progress, and that's huge. And it's really cool. It also syncs with your iTunes playlist, so your music is right there. And music is big for me too, so what I'm going to start doing is, I take it very seriously, sharing with you my playlists, because that's really big. Fitness, like I usually share, is mental and emotional for me. It is cleansing. It is a way to get my anger out, or my frustration, or my discontent. And in terms of trying new things and pushing my body, you know, it's totally mental and emotional, this entire journey. So I'm going to document every single Saturday my run and my progress. Sometimes it's going to be pretty, sometimes it's not. And it's also important to remember my times. Some people will scoff at them and look at them and say, wow, that's pathetic. I could run that when I was 12. Other people can't walk a mile. So it's really important to keep that perspective. It's all about your personal best and the fact that you're doing it and you're moving towards something. Being stagnant is something that I fear only because I want to make the most out of everything I've been given. I have legs that work. I have, you know, the freedom to go do these things, and I don't want to waste another day because I've wasted way too many. So without further ado, here is my second week of running. Hey guys, so it is Chelsea, and I just finished my second week of Saturday 5K runs, and I'm feeling really good. I'm really out of breath. Last week I ran a 34-minute 5K, and I think my average pace was 11 minutes, and it was super hot out, and I hadn't run in about almost a year. And how I first started losing weight was just walking, using the Nike running app. Along with Turbo Jam and clean eating, and I had just stopped once I started doing Insanity and P90X, and I decided to start running again. I think it's a really cool way to gauge your progress, another awesome way. I love keeping track of, you know, there's bugs all over me, you know, my progress. I think that's a really awesome way to stay motivated. It's not always your weight, it's not always your speed, it's not always you know, your measurements or how much you can lift. You can add them all together, and it's also how you feel too. You know, I really don't care if I'm not running a 7-minute mile. I feel really good about myself. So I went from a 34-minute 5K to a 29-minute 5K, approximately, I think. And I went from an 11-minute mile pace to a 9:19, which is huge for a week. So I think the weather had a lot to do with it. It was super hot. It was super hot last Saturday, and it's a little bit cloudy, and it's really nice out. So I live in a rural suburban area, about an hour and a half north of New York City, New York State, and it's summer and it's really buggy out. So
The way that I finish off my 5K run, where I have it mapped out, I live at the top of this hill. It's absolutely huge. So I just walk it out, and I also get a good butt workout. So I'm going to be sharing my runs with you guys. I definitely don't have the right shoes. I'm running in trainers. So before you jump on that, I know that is incorrect. My boyfriend just was sweet enough to buy me a pair of Asics running shoes because he's an experienced runner, and I want to keep up with him. I think that's really cool to have somebody who you love and you trust to keep you motivated and keep you on, doing the right things for your body and training correctly. So I just wanted to keep you posted with this. I also am going to share my playlists that I use. That is huge for me. The music that I listen to really keeps me in the right mindset when I'm running, because, or when I'm working out for that matter. Fitness for me is totally emotional and totally mental. And I think once you guys realize that, if you're struggling at all, you're going to have such a better time at embracing the tough stuff and creating a habit and just pushing through, because at the end of the day, workouts don't get easier. You just get better, and then you push yourself harder. And we just have to, hold on to the concept of failure. Failure is power. When you get knocked down, that means that you have been pushed as hard as you can be pushed, and then you're forced to stop. That's what failure is. Nobody wants to fail. And there are two kinds of people, the kinds that, I've been both. Some days I am, the kind that just stays down and gets depressed and anxious, or compare myself to other people who have better success than me. And that's not healthy. It's okay to fall into that, but it's not the way that we should look at exercise and ourselves and life for that matter. But there's all the other kind of person is the kind that, revels in failure and really enjoys it and accepts it and embraces it and longs for it and gets hooked on it.
We're not alone. There is more to this, I know. You can